In this video, I am going to show you how you can add a visualizer screen to your piano like this. So for the past few years, I've been making piano cover videos on this channel. And there is this one question that I get asked a lot in the comments. And so today, I'm finally making a tutorial video on how I do it. Okay, let's take a moment to understand what we'll cover in this tutorial. Our first goal is to transform a MIDI recording into a visualizer video. You've probably seen these videos before. This is like a dynamic display that shows the notes being played. Once we have the visualizer ready, we will then merge it with the live camera footage using Adobe After Effects. I'll break down the process step by step, so even if you are new to After Effects, you can still follow along. The first part of this video is going to be making our own MIDI visualizer video. Now, we can do that with different software like CMusic, Synvesia, but today I'm going to provide a free option, which is an open source software available on GitHub. So the link will be in the description below. Now, after you have opened the software, you will look like this on the screen. And the first thing you do is to load the MIDI file that you have. Click on Load MIDI file and select the MIDI file. After that, you can click Play, and you can see the MIDI file being rendered on the screen. The next thing you can do is to play around with these settings to customize the look that you want on this visualizer. Click on Show Effect Layers and disable some of the effects that you don't want. I will just leave the notes alone. After you have configured the settings and you have played around with, let's say, the color of the notes, you can press Export, choose MPEG-4, change the export size to 1920x1080, and then click Save Video 2. And then you can save the video to the location that you want. And after that, we can use the video in After Effects. Okay, so now we are in After Effects. Let me first show you what the final video looks like. Basically, there are three elements to it. The first layer is the camera footage. And on top of that, the second layer is the overlay, the visualizer that goes on top of the piano. And the third layer is the hands cutout. So it is a cutout of the hands that will go on top of the overlay. And if you combine all three of these layers, you will get this effect, the camera, the overlay, and then the hands going on top of the overlay. Okay, let's go back to the very beginning. Now, first of all, we need to import the two video files. The first file is the camera footage that is from the camera itself. The second footage is going to be the visualizer video file that was generated by the visualizer software earlier. Now, let's make a new composition from the camera footage file. We can do that by going to the project panel, right-clicking on the camera footage, select New Comp from Selection. After Effects should make a new comp with the camera footage inside. And let's rename this comp to something else. Right-click on the comp in the project panel, select Rename, and let's call it Main Video. Next, we are going to create another comp, but this time with the visualizer. Again, in the project panel, for the visualizer, right-click and choose New Comp from Selection. This comp is just a visualizer. Again, let's rename this comp to something else. Let's call it Overlay. This is going to be the overlay that appears on top of the piano. Now let's resize this overlay comp, because in the final video, this overlay is going to be long and narrow. So let's resize this comp by going to the top, select Composition, Composition Settings, and let's change the height of this comp to 500 pixels and click OK. Now the visualizer is getting cut off, so let's move the visualizer up so that we can see the part where the bars disappear. To do that, we can just select the visualizer, drag it up while holding shift, and we want it so that the part where the bars disappear is roughly in the middle of the comp. Okay, now I'm going to show you how you can make this saber effect, this horizontal bar that separates the falling notes from the piano keys. Let's go back to the overlay that we have, and we can do that by creating a new layer. Go to Layer, New, Solid, and let's call the solid Saber and click OK. In the effects panel, let's search Saber, and you should be able to see the saber effect if you have installed it beforehand. Now, drag the saber effect to the timeline, to the solid, and now we have applied the saber effect to the solid. However, you can see that the saber effect is not transparent and it is blocking the visualizer behind it. We can change the saber effect to be transparent simply by going to the effects control, go down to render settings, go to composite settings, and change black to transparent. Now you can see that the saber effect is transparent and we can see the visualizer behind it. Now let's drag the two handles that you see on the saber layer here so that it aligns to the position where the bars disappear. We can also change the position of the endpoints in the effects control. Let's make the x coordinate of the start point to be 1920 and the endpoint to be 0. For the y coordinates, it should be the same for the points because it's supposed to be perfectly horizontal. Let's make it 270 for both. We can also choose another preset here to match the style that you want and mess around with those other settings as well. Now let's press spacebar to preview the effect. Now that we have finished the overlay, let's go back to the main video and add the overlay to the main video. We can do that by going to the project panel. If you can't see it here, just click on the two arrows there and select project. Go back to the project panel and drag the overlay comp to the timeline above the camera footage. You see that the overlay comp still has a black background. And we can make it transparent by changing the blending mode of this layer. Let's go to the timeline, go to the overlay layer, and go to the blending mode columns here, and change normal to screen. Now the overlay layer should be transparent. Next, we are going to apply this corner pin effect to the overlay layer. In the effects panel, let's search power pin and drag the power pin effect to the overlay layer. Now we should be able to see four handles in the preview. After you have clicked on the effects control there, and you can also change the shape of the overlay layer. So now we are going to align this overlay with the piano as if it is like a screen in front of the piano. So let's drag the handles and move it in place. We can zoom in and hold spacebar to drag and move around so that we can place the corners more accurately, like so. Let's move it a little bit here. Okay, now we have the overlay effect on top of the piano. But it's still not aligned yet because we see that the saber effect and the bars are not aligned to the edge of the piano keys. So we can align that by going to the effects control under the power pin effect, expand the expansion option, and click, drag on the bottom value to the right until you see that the saber effect aligns with the edge of the piano keys. Okay, after we have aligned the position of the overlay, let's also adjust the timing so that the overlay layer is also in sync with the camera footage. To do that, let's go to the start of the clip. Let's zoom in on the timeline by holding alternate and scrolling up the mouse wheel. Let's go to the beginning of the video and find out the frame where I hit the first note on the piano. So let's go through it, and it should be this point here. So this is the moment where I play the first note. Okay, next we are going to go into the overlay layer by double clicking it in the timeline. Now let's change the timing of the visualizer layer now. Let's drag the visualizer layer to the left or the right, so that in the preview, you can see that the first note in the visualizer hits the saber effect in this same time. Okay, after doing that, let's go back to the main video and we can see that the timings are now aligned. We can also zoom out and jump forward to another part of the video and check if it is also in sync. Next, let's check again if the overlay is perfectly aligned to the piano keys. Let's zoom in a little bit and let's go to this part here. It looks like the visualizer is a bit off to the right. So let's further adjust the power pin effect here. Let's move the top left handle down a bit and change it so that it's more aligned to the piano keys. Let's zoom in and we can see that it is better now. Now we have finished the overlay layer. Next, we need to find a way to put the hands on top of the overlay. Right now, you can see that the hands are behind the visualizer. So we need to find a way to key out the hands from the camera footage and put it on top of the overlay. So there are many different ways to key out an object in After Effects, but the effect that I'm going to use today is called the difference map. Let's go back to the start of the timeline. Let's find a frame where there are no hands on the piano. So let's call this frame like a clean plate. First, we need to make a duplicate of this camera footage layer. So let's go to Edit and Duplicate. Let's mute this new layer and rename this layer to Clean Plate. Next, right-click on this clean plate and go to Time and select Freeze Frame. Now if we go through the timeline, you can see that this clean plate is not changing. Let's move this clean plate to the bottom of the comp. Let's make another duplicate of this camera footage. Let's go to Edit again and Duplicate. Now this time, let's rename this layer to Hands. Let's move this Hands layer on top of the overlay. Now we are going to key out the hands from this Hands layer. Let's go to the Effects panel and search Difference Mat. Drag the Difference Mat effect onto the Hands layer. In the Difference Layer option, select Clean Plate. It looks like nothing has changed, but if we only look at the Hands layer by itself, you can see that it is keying out the differences between this Hands layer here and the Clean Plate layer. Basically, it's doing subtraction and the result is the key that you see on the screen. Now let's change the matching tolerance setting so that you can see most of the hands being keyed out by this difference mat. Now if we set the tolerance too low, then you can see that it is picking up too much noise. But if it's too high, then it is cutting out too much of the hands. So we want it to be just the right amount so that it picks up almost all the hands and not too much of the noise outside of it. Now, if we look at everything again, now you can see that we have the hands going in front of the visualizers. We can further refine this matte using an effect called Refine Soft Matte. Drag this Refine Soft Matte and put it behind this Difference Matte effect. Now you should be able to see that this Refine Soft Matte effect has smoothened out the edges of this matte. You can also change the settings in this Refine Soft Matte effect and make it smoother. One last thing that we can do is to put a mask around this hands layer so that it only applies to the area covered by the overlay. Let's do that by clicking on a pen tool at the top and outlining a mask around this overlay. The reason for doing this is to avoid having extra noise outside of this overlay area. So the final video is going to be cleaner. And let's look at the final result here. And that wraps up our tutorial for creating this visualizer effect in After Effects. I only covered the basic effects that I use for my covers, and there are many more things that you can do to make it look even better. But that is for another time. If you enjoyed the tutorial, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more piano covers. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comments. See you next time!